knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Rheumatoid arthritis, or RA, is an autoimmune disease that occurs when a person's immune system mistakenly attacks normal proteins within the body. The resulting chronic inflammation primarily affects the synovium, or lining, of the joints, leading to swelling, stiffness, pain, and deformation of the joints. In about 40% of individuals, symptoms may also occur within the skin, lungs, muscles, and cardiovascular system. RA affects about 1 to 1.5% of people within North America and is 3 times more prevalent in women than men. According to CDC, the annual medical costs and earnings losses associated with arthritis came in at $303.5 billion in 2013, an amount equivalent to 1% of the gross domestic product of the United States that year. The need for anti-rheumatic drugs is immense, with a market size of $57 billion in 2019, which is expected to grow to $63 billion by 2027. Earlier in this series, we learned about NSAIDs, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. These drugs are common treatments for RA symptoms. However, they do not slow the progression of the disease or limit joint deformation. Many patients, especially with moderate to severe RA, are prescribed disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, or DMARDs. These drugs limit the underlying inflammation that causes RA, which not only decreases the pain associated with RA, but also prevents further damage to the joints, preserving their function. DMARDs consist of 2 different drug modalities, small molecule and biologic. Small molecule drugs are small compounds which bind to and either activate or deactivate a protein of interest. They can be administered and readily absorbed through various routes that we discussed earlier in the series. On the other hand, biologic DMARDs, or BDMARDs, are antibodies, which are protein complexes that are significantly larger than small molecules. While antibodies are normally generated by our immune system to guard us from invading organisms, pharmacologists can hijack this biological response to generate antibodies which target select proteins of interest with incredible specificity. These 2 modalities differ greatly in their production, cost, administration, and side effects. As proteins, biologic DMARDs must be made using biological processes rather than by the significantly simpler and cheaper chemical processes for small molecules. This also complicates their administration, as large proteins can't be absorbed by normal routes of administration and must be given by injection as often as once a week. Production, storage, and dosing difficulties contribute to the high expense of BDMARDs. As an example, Remicade, also known as infliximab, costs between $19,000 and $22,000 per year for treatment. Conversely, a treatment regimen of 1 to 2 small molecule DMARDs can achieve disease remission in many RA patients. Therefore, due to dosing difficulties and high costs, biologic DMARDs are only prescribed for moderate to severe RA in cases when non-biologic DMARDs fail to sufficiently relieve disease symptoms. Both modalities in this drug class are commonly combined with NSAIDs for the treatment of the pain associated with inflammation. Small molecule DMARDs are associated with a range of side effects. Due to the highly specific nature of the antibody interaction with proteins, the side effects are generally lower in this class. However, they have been associated with uncommon adverse events, including decreased white or red blood cell counts, lymphoma, demyelinating disease, and heart failure. Both of these classes, however, are immunosuppressive and lead to an increased risk for various opportunistic infections by bacterial, fungal, or viral agents that would not cause infection in an individual with normal, uncompromised immune function. Though DMARDs were originally classified for the treatment of RA, their immunosuppressive effects make them efficacious treatments for many other immune disorders, including plaque psoriasis, ankylosing spondylitis, Crohn's disease, and ulcerative colitis. Let's now move forward and look at a specific anti-rheumatic drug so we can better understand its mechanism of action.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.